While many Australian households are right now feeling the pinch of cost of living, some are going to drastic lengths just to survive.
New research by the Salvation Army revealing children are going without medical care, while some families are using public bathrooms and living in darkness just to reduce their bills.
It is heartbreaking. We're joined now by Lauren Martin from the Salvos and also Owen Davies, who has accessed the charity support over the years. Good to see you both.
Thanks for coming in.
On a really special day. Lauren, to you, firstly, just talk us through some of these findings.
Yeah, so every year we survey a number of the community members that come to us for assistance and we ask them what they're struggling with. I'm a community worker on the ground and the findings of the report correlate with what we're seeing on the ground every day. So more and more people are making those really, really hard choices. Every week I'm being told by people that they cannot afford their prescription medication. They have to make that really hard choice between, do I get my prescription medication, which I need for my health, or do I buy groceries so that we can feed the family? Feeding the family always wins out, of course, because parents are not going to let their kids go hungry. We often have parents say, I just tell my kids I'm not hungry, I just have a cup of tea at dinner instead so that they can eat, so that they can send their kids to school with a full lunchbox. The other thing we're seeing is that more and more people are coming to us for the very first time, because what seems to have happened is that many Australians have lost their buffer. So they've lost shifts at their work, or they've become ill and they've run out of their sick leave pay and they have to take leave without pay. Whereas before they might have a savings buffer to get them through till they can come out the other side, that's completely gone, because cost of living and interest rate rises and all those things. So we're seeing people that have never before had to ask for help. They've been the one helping the Salvation Army and they're embarrassed and they're ashamed, but they come to us and we can come alongside them with, food support, we can help with their utilities and things like that.
I mean, this is Australia.
Yeah, that's right. And financial stress, we know that affects all sorts of other things with people. It affects people's, physical health. It affects people's mental health. It affects people's relationship health. So it's a real long knock-on effect for people. And as you said, in your intro, people are going to drastic measures. Every year when it gets colder, people that live below the poverty line in Australia, they don't use their heaters. That's just a regular thing. But now what they're saying is they're not using their lights.
Can we bring you in, Owen, if possible? So 20 years ago, you were living on the streets.
Yeah.
Just give us an idea of your situation.
So my whole life was changed overnight, pretty much. Everything I knew was just changed. And I was 13 when I first became homeless. And I was alone. I was in the dark. When I first became homeless, I was still going to school, so I didn't really know what to do, My whole life was going to school and being at home, and so I was sleeping in a train station toilets and I was trying to go to school from there. And it was pretty much one of the darkest times of my life. I had no direction. I had really no hope.
And 13 is such an a crucial time in your life. You have got support from the Salvos. What kind of difference does that make for you?
It makes all the difference in the world. Before I met the Salvation Army, I was a little bit out of control. I had no real, care for anything. And I was sort of seen as a number, instead of a person. But the Salvation Army, they were the first people to actually look at me like a person, have care in their hearts and treat me like a member of their family, They really turned my life around. Without them, I'd probably be in jail or dead.
I can hear the emotion in your voice.
Yeah.
It means so much to you, the work of the Salvos, I dare say.
Yeah, definitely. Without the Salvos, things would be a lot worse.
And without the people who donate to the Salvos, what would the Salvos do? Lauren, your Red Shield appeal today.
That's right.
You want to raise $38 million this year.
Yep, a big call.
How can people help?
Look, we're going to see us out and about all this weekend in front of shopping centres, at your local sporting grounds. If you don't see us, jump online at salvationarmy.org.au or you can donate at 13 Salvos, that's 1372.58. We're aiming to raise $38 million and that's because people need it. Our people are saying that they're not actually going to get by week to week unless they can come and see us regularly for that food support and the bill support and the financial assistance, emergency financial assistance.
Hey Owen, there's a lot of people watching this morning who will be doing it tough. What would you say to them?
I'd say to them that don't give up, because this isn't the end. This is just temporary. And at the end of the day, the only person who can hold you back is yourself. So stand up and, stand up and walk forward. And if you do need help, reach out to the Salvation Army, because they're always there and they're always there to listen and support if you need it, if you need food, if you need accommodation, anything, just reach out to
them. It's a beautiful message, mate. You're so brave.
Is.
Thank you so much for sharing your story and thank you for the work that the Salvos do.
Thanks for your support.
You guys are amazing. Yeah. Just amazing, both of you.
Thank you.
And for more on the Red Shield Appeal, head to salvationarmy.org.au.
And give if you can.
Concerns are being raised over how much tax Queensland homeowners are paying, with the government raking in $3.5 billion extra in stamp duty over the past 3 years. We have today Queensland reporter Ashlyn Krakelis in Brisbane with more. Ash, homeowners are paying hundreds of thousands of dollars to the government.
Sophie, and a house itself is expensive enough, but this new research from the Property Council of Australia has found that Queenslanders are spending around a third of their mortgage on government taxes and fees, things like land taxes, GST, council rates and stamp duty. In fact, the research has found that the Queensland government has made $17 billion in revenue from stamp duty alone in the last 3 years, which is $3.5 billion more than it expected to make in this time. So this morning, the Property Council is calling on Premier Stephen Miles and the Queensland government to review stamp duty costs and especially to consider increasing the threshold for the first home buyer grant. At the moment, Queenslanders can buy their first home without paying stamp duty if it costs less than $500,000, but the median house price in Brisbane is right now above $800,000. So the Property Council says a review is well overdue to help more people enter an increasingly difficult housing market. Soph?
Certainly makes it hard to get ahead. Ashlyn, thank you.
As tax time nears and those household bills pile up, millions of Australians are right now banking on a cash injection from the tax man.
But once that money lands in your bank account, how should you go about spending it? Finders Graham Cook joins us now in the studio with more. Morning, Graham.
Hey, Graham.
So we know that everybody's doing it tough financially at the moment. How many Australians are really desperate to get that tax return?
This year it's going to be about 9 million Australians expecting a tax refund. Of that group, 1 in 10 say they will find that tax refund critical to their finances. Another 25% say it's very important. So quite a few people desperate for that tax refund this year.
On average, I think it's about $1,000 they're sort of looking at in that tax return. What areas do you think are hurting households the most?
That's a good question. So Finders Cost of Living Pressure Gauge, which measures the pressure on households due to the cost of living, currently at 77% in the extreme range. It's being driven by the cost mainly of putting a roof over your head, so rent and mortgage, groceries, energy and petrol. So those are the four biggest cost issues for households right now.
So how much can most people expect to get in their return? And, I mean, is it even going to make a dent?
Yes, yeah, so like you said, it's around $1,000. It's a bit different between men and women, so there's a salary gap here too. About $1,200 for women, about $1,300 for men. So it's not a huge gap, but there is a gap there.
Okay. So how can people sort of maximise the return they get? That's a big question.
Yeah, this is key. The more you claim, the more you can get back. So generally look at the things that you spend on for work, travel, not to and from work, but for work you can claim. Things like clothes and dry cleaning. This jacket, for example, I can claim the dry cleaning for this because I use it for TV. Yeah. If you pay for courses, you can claim those back. There's quite a big list. If you want a full guide, I've written one. It's on the front page of Finder today, and that has all the other deductions you can make. And also, if you go today, you'll see the brand new Finder website, which we just relaunched yesterday.
Ooh, snazzy.
With a new look and new content. Very snazzy indeed, yeah.
We'll check it out.
Thanks, Graham.
Thanks, guys.
Good tips.